I never thought I'd see the day my mum would get up and make something of herself. I prayed for this every day, for a whole year. I guess there is a God.
I knew one day I'd love again, work again, be Vanessa and not mum, but I never thought I'd go back to college.
How did you feel when I signed you up to Croydon College?
I was nervous, because I ain't been in college since I was like 16 or 17, so I was thinking, oh my gosh, how am I going to cope, like, with random people and the work? Because I've always been at home with the kids.
How's college different to in the 90s?
It's not really different. When I was younger, I wasn't really interested in the work that I was given, but now I'm more taking in the work and doing it and getting it on time, because I'm older now.
How did you feel on your first day?
I was kind of nervous, but once I got into it, started talking to people, it wasn't that bad.
How were your classmates?
Irritating, don't even like to go there. They're annoying.
How's your tutor?
Well, my first tutor, he's not there anymore. He left. I prefer him better than the one I have now. The other one, to be honest, I think she should be in college. She's not very professional.
What motivates you to keep going?
Well, I want to get a good job in it. So at the end of the day, if I don't stay in college, I'm not going to get anywhere. And my children, yourself, you lot keep me going to go to college. And my husband.
Do you enjoy your days off college?
It's alright, but sometimes I have to do coursework, so I use that to do my coursework if I have any. Otherwise, I'll just use that to tidy up the house, get things done, because I don't get a chance to do it in the week.
Do you get bored?
I did at first, but now I don't, because the people in my class get on my nerves, so I'm kind of glad to get away from them on my days off. Do you get bored on your days off?
No, I like my days off. I just like to stay in bed.
Is that what you do? Just stay in bed when I'm downstairs or in my college?
Get up and get food or go shop.
Okay.
Have you ever thought of like having a break?
What? A break? What, holiday?
Like just giving up.
Yeah, I have. That's because a lot of things have happened in the time that I've been at college. Like, last month, October, I found out that Nanny's ill, isn't it? And she's going to die any time between 6 months to a year. They're giving her 6 months to a year to live. So that's kind of like knocked me back a bit. But I'm really trying my hardest to stay focused at college. But at the same time, it's hard.
How do you cope with it?
I don't know. I just try my best. But sometimes I feel like I don't want to do anything.
The college
supported. They are, but I think they could be better in supporting, but they're not as supportive as they make out to be.
Yeah, like, I remember when I was in fashion and the teachers didn't even care.
They don't care. It's all about making herself look good. I don't care at the end of the day. They're just rude.
How do you feel about going to the university where your mum attends the college?
I don't really mind her coming, because at the end of the day, she's doing something for herself. And I don't really see her because I'm in the art department and she's doing health and social care.
Why did you sign her up?
I signed her up because for a while now she'd been talking about she wants to do something, she wants to find a job. But I know it's hard to find a job with no qualifications, so I signed her up for the college. And as none of her kids are at home anymore, they're all in school, I just signed her up.
Right. Do you find it weird that you're finished off your education as your mum is just starting?
Yeah, it is a bit weird, but at the end of the day, she had me when she was quite young, and she didn't really have the best upbringing either. So I guess it took for me to grow up to show her that she can do it as well.
Cool. How did you find growing up around domestic violence?
I would say I just learnt to deal with it. It's something that happened, and there's nothing I can change about it, to be honest.
Do you sometimes feel you play the second mum?
Yes. Everyone comes to me with their problems. They moan to me when they get in trouble. And my little sister calls me mum.
Do you feel like you've had to grow up a lot quicker before your time?
Yeah. I don't think I really had a good childhood, I don't know. I was a child, but I was always looking out for my mum and everyone else. But then I've always had friends that have helped me be me.
How do you feel about mummy going back to college?
I feel really pleased for her because I know that she'll get a good education. She'll be able to help us in life.
I feel really pleased that my mum can go back to college because she'll be able to socialise more and she'll be able to concentrate when it comes to her home.
Yeah.
Yes, because when I've got my days off from work, I've got company at home. And no, in a way, as she's got her life back, as in she can go out, learn and get her education and get her life back on the road as a person, as well as a mother and a husband and as a wife.
When I first found out that my mum was going to college, I felt really happy because I've been praying for her to get into a good college so that she can get a good job and a good opportunity to get more money, and when she needs something when she needs help or something, she'll remember all those times when she was at college and she did all those things to help her.
Are you proud of her?
Yeah, of course.
Do you miss her being at home?
I'm not here anyway, because I'm at college with her, so... Yeah, I don't miss her that much. I see her all the time on break.
Did you ever think that she would go back to college?
No, she didn't even want to anyway. We forced her.
I was 18. I was 19 when I had you.
Well, tell me the story about what happened.
Well, basically, I didn't know that I was pregnant and had a pregnancy test, and it came up. First, it came up negative, and in a couple of days, it came up. I had to do another one, and it was positive within like 2 days. They said, come back. And then after that, they said, when was my last period? I said, I don't know. I was just taking pills here and everywhere, thinking that I was protecting myself. And then one time my belly was like really swollen, and Nanny said to me, I told Nanny that I was pregnant. She was like really happy. We didn't understand why, because I couldn't have that reaction towards you if you came home at 18 and said, Mum, I'm pregnant. Mm. But I had my scan, because Nanny was worried, because what it was, she was saying to me, oh, do you know when your last period? I said, no. So she said, well, you better bloody go and have that scan then, because that baby looked like it, that baby looked like it's ready to drop. But when I had my scan, I was only, I think I was 8 weeks pregnant. And that, and then after I came to terms that I was really going to have a baby, and seeing it on the scan made me excited to know that I'm going to be a mum. I didn't really think about my future at that stage. I was just thinking that I'm going to be a mum. I was just thinking about running around buying baby clothes and getting new stuff for you and stuff like that.
Yeah, how was with that?
He was shocked. He didn't talk to me.
Why?
He wasn't ready to be a dad, I suppose. But he wasn't responsible at that time. He was quite immature and stuff. So I think that might have been why he wasn't ready. He just wanted to run around and do what he was doing.
When you had me, did you have any career plans or anything?
Nope. No, not at the time. I was just, that wasn't even in my mind. I just had this newborn baby and I was just focusing on just being a mum to you at the time. That was it.